Hey guys, everybody kind of has their days where it just seems that everything that you're making doesn't really meet your own standards, and sometimes it's just you're seeing a lot of artwork and you're comparing yourself to it. I usually just take inspiration from that. It's not a lack of inspiration, but just things aren't coming out how you envision. Something gets lost in translation between your brain and your hand. So making thumbnails can be like a low stress place to work it out before putting a lot of time into sketching, doing line art and stuff like that. It sucks to work on one piece of the art for a long time and then it doesn't turn out right in the end because something just didn't work. That's why some people play it really safe by sketching out different compositions, trying different color schemes in the sketchbook before you actually do the thing. And some people don't really play it very safe and just jump in, and that's okay too. It used to be that I would just not do anything and just say, you know, this is okay, and I don't have to make art all the time. I have a full-time job, and I'm not stressing every single day about whether or not I can eat. So I have a huge privilege in that I can just, you know, sit back and write it out. So when I don't feel like I'm making anything good, art journaling is good for that. This little tiny book, it's the cheapest paper, you know, I think it's some kind of really, really thin craft paper. It's not good for a lot of stuff. This book, I'm only a few pages in and it's already, the cover is literally already falling off. And that's okay because this is a book for playing. I wouldn't even use it to test out materials because materials aren't designed to work on this. It's like a little garbage book. So, and I'm really enjoying it. And I really like having this little designated spot to malfunction in. And some pages turn out okay, and a lot of pages don't. There's a lot of pages that I think are ugly, or I hate this green and orange color scheme, or this is just not good, but this is the place for it. And so, yes, I started out this page with a, you know, nice little poppy sketch with pencil crayons, and it was looking okay, and then I started adding layers, and it's one of those things where you cover up something that you like and it just doesn't really work out. And I know from watching other people that if you don't like a layer, just keep adding more layers until you find something you like. But in this particular page, it just seemed like I liked it less and less with every layer. And I suppose I could just keep going. But again, when you're feeling kind of demotivated, nothing's coming out right, you just don't want to keep going. I've added this little shadowy figure that follows people around and just throws crap on things and leaves a trail of, you know, so that he can find his way back and leave more crap on things, and you know, it's you can't help it, he's cute, he looks a little sad too, so. I kind of actually like the found poem on this one. But yeah, everyone kind of gets that way, and you just kind of have to, either have to forgive yourself for letting it play out, or you can force yourself to do something. So in conclusion, if you're feeling kind of demotivated, like you're not really making anything good, if you're able to just ride it out, just go ahead and ride it out. Don't feel pressured to create when you don't have to. But when you force yourself to do a little bit of art when you don't feel like it, sometimes you can kind of kickstart something inside of yourself and get whatever crud was building up out onto the paper, and then allowing all the good stuff to come out afterward.